Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Hamza Al-Anani. Now we'll talk about a very, 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 very important companion. The Prophet, peace be upon him, gave them the glad tidings that they are in paradise. So this companion is named Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. So let's talk about him. So Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, before he entered Islam, some people named him Abd Amr, and some people named him Abd al-Harith, and some people named him Abd al-Ka'ba. So this is all, these names are not good, and they're bad names. So then when he entered Islam, Prophet, peace be upon him, changed his name into Abd al-Rahman. Okay, so when Abu Bakr came to Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf to make him enter Islam, he knew that Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf had good reputation and good behavior with people. So when he wanted him to enter Islam, he entered Islam immediately. So three examples we have to know about Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf. It's very, very, very important. So Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf entered Islam 10 years younger than the Prophet, peace be upon him. The second example, he was from the top eight, the first top eight who accepted the deen of Allah. So the last example is, he was always with the Prophet, peace be upon him, to struggle the Kuffar of Quraysh. Kuffar of Quraysh was a very bad people. They obey someone else than Allah. Okay, so one day when the reputation came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, to emigrate to Medina, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf is one of the ones who decided to emigrate with the Prophet, peace be upon him, to Medina. So before he go, Kuffar of Quraysh say to him, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, if you want to go, you can go, but leave your world behind in Mecca. So Abdul Rahman ibn Auf don't leave every single penny with him. He left all his wealth in Mecca, but he want to go to immigrate to Medina to all the Muslims, to all the prophets and sahaba. So when he go, he was very poor, and he was alone. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, formed a bond of neighborhood with another sahabi named Rabi'ah. So he said, that all the people in Medina know that I am the wealthiest people amongst them. So here's my wealth, the half of it is yours. And I have two wives, choose one of them. So Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf make a dua for the sahabi. He said, may Allah bless your wealth and wives. But can you show me where is the market? Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf didn't give hope. He want to be a businessman again. So after days, Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf was married. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, make for him a dua about barakah for his wealth and barakah for his family. So when the Prophet make a dua for Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf, Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf said, the dua of the Prophet was so powerful that all the people came to my feet. Can you believe it? So you must know that the money of Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf was not in his heart. It was in his hands, okay? So one day, Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf has to perform al-Fajr prayer, and the Prophet was not back yet. So he told Bilal to make adhan, and then they pray. He prayed one rak'ah, and then the Prophet came, and then he prayed with Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf the last rak'ah. So the two who the Prophet pray with is Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf and Abu Bakr Siddiq. Before he died, he left all his money behind and gave it all the people. Okay, so he died. He died in al-Hijrah, so 32 of al-Hijrah, and he died when he was about 72 years old, and he was buried in al-Baqi'. Okay, so I hope you learned many things about Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf. Inshallah, all of you will be like him, inshallah. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.